Hey guys, so today I am working on something really cool and I wanted to show you guys what it is. So right now I have the machined part of this speaker ring. So today we're gonna finish this off, this little project. That's why I brought my router table, so that I can do the edges of this, and then we'll have some acrylic on there, and you guys, you'll get to see exactly what I'm going for with this project. This is a deburring tool. The edges of the plastic have flash when it comes off of the router because of the bit. That's just some leftover plastic on the edges. This has a blade that'll get it off and make it nice and smooth. Now the table router, the bits need depth. I needed it deeper than what it really was to get the edge that I wanted. So I had to make this ring and screw it to my existing ring to get the depth I needed for the bit to work properly. You can see here the edges meet up nice and it'll roll on the guide of the router bit perfectly. Don't forget your safety glasses. There's a lot of chip from this. I set the depth to where I wanted now. Let it go. That was the roundover bit. Then I changed over to the chamfer bit or the angle bit, whatever you want to call it. I have an angled inside edge and the roundover on the outside edge of the ring. switch up the geometry a little bit. Makes it more interesting, I think. So here's what it is that I'm working on. Actually, I'm thinking of making this as a product for Sparked Innovation. So this is kind of the prototype. And the idea is that we'd get different sizes for various woofers and allow you to customize the acrylic inserts and maybe even some of the size and style. So there's a channel cut on the bottom of this that will fit over the lip of this basket. And the holes, of course, line up to the mounting holes. And so it should pressure fit on to that channel. And it does. So one of the things it's doing is clamping down the surround more, making it a stronger woofer. And I'll get some close-ups. Here's your taco, sir, of this. But I'm trying to do the kind of countersunk screw. But that's the acrylic I cut earlier. I have it designed for two pieces, and these would just sit in this pocket. And although this pressure fits in, what I would probably do is actually use adhesive to make that permanent. And this goes on under, if you peel off the factory rubber gasket around there. And yeah, I'd use double-faced tape for the acrylic or adhesive. Now I'm getting all fingerprinted up. So before I get close-ups, I'm gonna wipe this down so you can see it. Oh yeah, it's looking really nice. So I want you guys to let me know, leave a comment below on what do you think of this as a product. How do you think, what kind of woofers do you have that you think this would look good on? What kind of woofers do you want that you think this, would you use something like this? You know, it's an idea for now, and it's something that I have to tweak a little bit and get some measurements of various woofers out there, but it's definitely something that we can do and make it look really nice.